Hello and welcome back. In other videos, we show you how to import data, visualize data, or create a model. In this video, we'll focus on applying a model. If you want to follow along, you can download the data file and import it. The data loading process video will show you how it is done, and you can import the process files as well. So let's get started. First thing we'll do is to create a copy of one of our previous processes, namely 02 Build Decision Tree Model, as the basis for our next actions. So we right-click it and select Copy. To paste it into our existing folder, we can just right-click the subfolder Processes and select Paste. Then we choose Insert Copy of Entry, and finally we rename our process, again by using the right mouse button, and call it 03 Apply the Model. So why do we call it Apply the Model? In the video on how to create a model, we built a decision tree, and we talked a little bit about how, based on our sample of data, somebody belongs to a certain branch based on their gender, age, and last transaction characteristics. But following the tree for every customer by just doing it by hand is a tedious way of doing things. Hence, now we want to do it automatically using RapidMiner Studio, and this action is commonly referred to as applying a model. Okay, so let's review the steps which our process does for us so far. The process loads in data, then filters out some of the examples, and creates a decision tree. To get a preview on the data, we can hover over the out port of the retrieve operator and hit the F3 key to pin the pop-up. We can see now where the data has come from, how many attributes we have, and that churn is our special attribute, with the role label, for which we want to predict the 96 missing examples. The filter examples operator was used to remove the examples without information in the label before we built the model to predict the missing information for those examples. So now we need to separate out from our data those customers which we want to predict, which we want to label as potential loyal or churn customers. To do so, we will create a second branch where we only filter out and keep the missing ones to which we can apply the model we built in the first branch. So how will we do that? Quite easily. Let's go ahead and select these operators here by dragging a window and just moving them a little bit down the connection. And since we're going to use another filter example operator, let's go look for that now and drag it into the process panel. Before we define the connection between the operators, there is one thing to keep in mind. In RapidMiner, one output port can only be connected to one other port. If I connect the retrieve operator with our new filter operator, then the other one disconnects automatically. Well, is there a way that I can make a copy of this data and feed one branch into here and another branch into here? Yes, the way we do that is with the multiply operator. You can do it by getting it from the operators panel, but RapidMiner has another very handy way of making a multiplication. If I just drag this connection again over here now to the filter example, then you'll see another little icon show up. If you click on this icon, it will create a second branch by making a copy of the data through automatically applying the multiply operator. This looks a little messy, so let's go use our right mouse button to clean this up. Hover over on this output port, right-click and disconnect. Oh, RapidMiner already moved the remaining connection to the top position and left me another port. Let's reconnect that one then to our new filter operator, and then we can proceed to set the parameters. Remember, we only want the examples with a missing entry in the label to remain in the second example set. We will select the Add Filters, and we'll set it to the Churn attribute, and then choose the option Is Missing. Now let's hit OK, and let's connect the branch to the results. Let's briefly review before we hit the Run Process button. The process we created will retrieve the data, and we'll make two copies of it. It will then filter out for one example set the loyal and churn and keep them to build a decision tree and create another branch which will only filter out the missing values and we'll port them both together over here. Let's run the process now and let's inspect the data. Great, you can see here that I have 96 examples and they have nothing in the churn column. Great, and of course from the other branch we have our decision tree tab here, which we inspected and discussed in the respective video. We have to do one more step now. Let's go back to the design view. Now what we need to do is we need to take the model that we built in the upper branch and we need to apply it to the unscored example set of the lower branch so we can score or put those examples into the loyal or churn bucket. If you listened carefully, you just heard me basically say that we need to apply the model. And if you look to the recommended operators, you can immediately see that apply model is for us the next recommended step by our wisdom of the crowds. I'm saying next step even though we see two other recommendations first, but we already know that we will use all attributes, and we'd already defined the role during loading. So let's pull in Apply Model and drop it on the upper branch where it can pick up the model information. Now to combine the upper and lower branch, we can just drag the operator with the connection down here and drop it on the lower branch. So what did RapidMiner do here? It automatically connected the MOD, which stands for model output, to the MOD input of our Apply Model operator. Then when we dropped it on the lower branch, it connected EXA output, which are our examples after filtering, and connected them to the UNL port. UNL stands for unlabeled data, which are our examples with missing or question mark in the label attribute. In our case, the label we're looking for is churn or loyal. So let's switch back and take a look at the output of the Apply Model operator. So this output part will now give us predicted labels for our examples, and the second connection will output the model again too. Let's take a moment to save our process first before running it. I'm doing it with shortcuts this time. First, Control-S or Command-S, and the F11. Congratulations, we just did some predictions. Now let's take a look at the results. I have my churn attribute, which we defined as label, with the missing entries. And also I have three new special attributes. I have a prediction attribute, and I have confidence for loyal, and a confidence for churn. For this example, the model is predicting that this candidate, who is female, 39 and paid by credit card, and has at last transaction of 177 days, will churn. It has a 79.8% confidence that it has correctly put them in that churn bucket. But what about the ones that are loyal? Let's come down here to this person. The model says it has a 89% confidence that it is a loyal person who happens to be a male, 63, and paying by credit card. Congratulations on your first prediction, on applying and scoring the data. The next step in the predictive analytics lifecycle is to actually validate your results, to get a true perspective on how good your model is before you can operationalize it. Because ultimately, you want to have the confidence that the model is correct and will give you the correct predictions going forward. Thank you very much for watching.